Students, in previous lecture, we discussed about the sixth lesson, that is composition of matter. See here, today we are going to discuss about the next lesson, that is metals and non-metals. So see here, student, this is the seventh lesson in our textbook, metals and non-metals. So students, in previous lecture we studied the different states of matter, that are solid, liquid, gaseous, plasma, and fifth one, that is the Bose-Einstein condensate. So these are the states of matter. So matter is divided into the different groups or different types. See here, their types are elements, compounds, and mixture. This all we see in the previous lesson. But in this lesson, matters are also, or elements are also, classified in three types that are called as metals, non-metals, and third type is metalloids. So today we are going to discuss about the all these types of elements. So see here, student, this is the seventh lesson, metals and non-metals, in which first question is, what are the three types in which the elements are generally classified? Now we tell you that types, that are metals, non-metals, and metalloids. So next question is, what are the metals and non-metals that we use in everyday life? So different metals and non-metals we use in our daily life. So see here, all the objects or materials in the world are made from elements, compounds, or their mixtures. Scientists classified all the elements into three general types, which are metals, non-metals, and metalloids. So students, which are the metals? So metals, examples of metals are gold, silver, iron, copper, aluminium, magnesium, calcium, sodium, and platinum. These are the few examples of metals. Other examples are manganese. More examples of metals are manganese, cobalt, zinc, barium, lithium, beryllium, potassium. These are the few examples of metals. So see here, metals have luster. So student, what is mean by luster? Luster means chamakne. Metals kashe astat? Shiny astat. Luster means shiny. So that is, metals are shining, chamaktat te. The metals are hard. Wire or sheet can be made from them, made metal. Metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. Metals lose their valence electrons to produce positively charged ions, that is cations. So students, these all points we discussed in next point. That next point is the physical properties of metals and non-metals. So student, now we are going to discuss about the physical properties of metals and non-metals. First of all, we discussed about the physical properties of metals only. So see here, first physical property of metal is physical state. So see here, metals are under ordinary temperature stay in solid state. So generally, at ordinary temperature, metals are solid. However, metals like mercury and gallium, these are the एक्सेप्शनल केसेस विच आर इन लिक्विड स्टेट इवन ऐट रूम टेम्परेचर. सो स्टूडेंट प्लीज यू रिमेंबर दैट थिंग्स. जो मर्क्यूरी एंड गैलियम दीज टू मेटल्स आर द एक्सेप्शन बिकॉज दीज मेटल्स आर इन लिक्विड टेम्परेचर सॉरी लिक्विड स्टेट एट रूम टेम्परेचर. अदर मेटल्स आर इन सॉलिड स्टेट. अंडरस्टैंड? ओके. सी हियर सेकेंड प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मेटल इज लस्टर. सो स्टूडेंट व्हाट इज मीन बाय लस्टर? लस्टर मीन्स शाइनिंग. सो सी हियर टेक अ कॉपर वेसल एट युअर होम स्क्रब देम विथ लेमन एंड रिंस विथ वॉटर. ऑब्जर्व द लस्टर बिफोर एंड आफ्टर क्लीनिंग. लाइट gets reflected from the clean or freshly cut surface of the metal and metal looks lustrous. So students, all the metals having the property lustrous because metals are shines. When we cut that surface of metal, it shines. So see here, metals like gold, silver, copper. We see the copper wire, we see the silver ornaments, we see the gold ornaments, we see the aluminium vessels, we see the irons. These metals are shining. Understand? Third property is hardness. Generally, metals are hard, exception sodium and potassium, because these are soft and these sodium and potassium can be easily cut by a knife. So generally all the metals are hard except sodium and potassium because sodium and potassium are soft metals. So next property of metal is ductility. So student, what is mean by ductility? So ductility means the ability of metal to make small wire of that metal, that is ductility. So see here, we go to the goldsmith shop. What is goldsmith? जे सराफ आहेत किंवा सोनार म्हणतो आपण त्यांना, ठीक आहे. त्या सोनाराच्या दुकानामध्ये ज्या वेळेला आपण जातो, वी सी द डिफरंट ऑर्नामेंट्स ऑफ गोल्ड अँड सिल्वर. दीज ऑर्नामेंट्स आर मेड बाय दी wire of gold and silver. So when a metal is pulled through a hole, its wire is formed, and that property of forming a wire is called as ductility. So all the metals have the property ductile or ductility, or all the metals are ductile because they are converted into the wire, fine wire. So next property of metal is malleability. So see here, what is malleable? These are malleability means the capable of being shaped by hammering. So see here, malleable property. Take an iron nail, place it on a platform and keep on hammering it. After some time you will see a thin sheet forming. This property is called as malleability of metals. So malleability means the ability to form a thin sheet by hammering on that metal. That property is called as malleability, and all the metals are malleable. So see here, next property is conduction of heat. So students, we see at our home the copper wires which are conducts the electricity. See here, so metals are the good conductors of heat. Silver, copper and aluminium are the best conductors of heat. So see here, all the metals are the conductors of heat. यांच्यामधून काय होते? heat pass hoti if we use aluminium vessels in kitchen. If we put these aluminium vessels on heat or on gas flame, that aluminium vessel conducts heat and it becomes hot. So all the metals are good conductors of heat. Next property is conduction of electricity. So in our home, student, we see the copper is the which copper wire which are conducts the heat. So metals are the good conductors of electricity. All the metals are good conductors of electricity. Lead is an exception, which is neither a good conductor of heat or a good conductor of electricity. Except lead. Lead is an exception, which is not a good conductor of heat and electricity also. So see here, students, metals are good conductors of heat and electricity except lead. So next property of metal is density. So see here, metals have high density, sodium, potassium, lithium are the exception having lower density than water. See here, the density of lithium is only 0.53 gram per cubic centimeter. So see here, all the metals having high density except sodium, potassium and lithium. These having the lower density than water means all the metals which are sinks in water except sodium, potassium and lithium, because these all having lower density than water. So these are floats on water. Next point is melting point and boiling point. So student, what is melting point and what is boiling point? If we give heat to a solid, that solid melts. At which temperature that solid is melt? That is melting point. And what is meant by boiling point? If we provide a heat to a liquid and the some temperature or at which temperature that liquid starts boiling, that temperature is called as boiling point of that liquid. So that is the difference between melting point and boiling point. Generally, metals have high melting point and high boiling points. Exceptions are Hg. What is Hg, students? Hg means what? So see here, student, what is Hg? That Ga means gallium, Na means sodium, K means potassium. What is Hg? Hg is the example of, it is the symbol of mercury, that is hydrargium, that means mercury. It is gallium, Na means sodium and K means potassium. So next property of metal is sonority. What is sonority? Sonority means the objects which produce sound on striking, that is sonority. So all the metals have the sonorous property, because if we struck any metal, that metal produces sound. So student, we see in our school there is a school bell, and that school bell is made up of iron, and iron is the metal. So we hear the school bell because iron, if we school bell is rang, then iron produces the sound on striking. So these are all the properties of metals. So student, you have to remember or learn all the properties of metals, like physical state, luster, hardness, ductility, malleability, conduction of heat and electricity, density, melting point and boiling point, and last one is sonority. So students, now we see the next point, that is non-metals. So which are the non-metals? So see here, carbon, sulfur, phosphorus are the few non-metals. Except these, nitrogen, oxygen, noble gases like fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, selenium, these are also the non-metals. So we are going to discuss about the physical properties of non-metals. First physical property of non-metal is physical state. So see here, at ordinary temperature, non-metals occur at solid, liquid and gaseous. For examples, which are the solids? Carbon, sulfur, phosphorus. These non-metals are at solid at room temperature. Which non-metal is liquid at room temperature? That is bromine. And which are the gases? Hydrogen, nitrogen and oxygen. These are the gaseous at room temperature. So second property of non-metal is luster. Non-metals do not have luster except diamond and iodine crystals. Some non-metals are colorless while others have different color. So see here, non-metals do not have luster property except diamond and iodine. So diamond is made up of carbon, that is a non-metal which is lustrous. These are the exceptional cases, and iodine crystals. So see here, some non-metals are colorless while other have different colors. So student, there is one question: what is the color of carbon in the form of coal? We all of you know that coal is made up of carbon. So what is the color of coal? Black. So carbon is black. Sulfur is yellow and bromine is brown in color. So this is the physical state and luster property of non-metal. Next we discuss the property that is brittleness. So all the non-metals are brittle. So what is brittle? Brittleness, thistle. These are easily, brittleness means these are easily breakable. So see here, take a coal and hammer it. See what happens to it. We know that solid non-metals are brittle. Some non-metals are soft. Diamond, what is diamond? It is an allotrope of carbon, is an exception case, because diamond is the very hardest natural substances. Don't please remember that diamond is very hardest natural substances. So all the non-metals are brittle. Understand? Next property is ductility and malleability. What is ductile? Property to form a thin wire. And malleability means capable to being shaped by hammering. So non-metals are nor ductile nor malleable, and metals are ductile and malleable, and non-metals are not ductile and not malleable. Next properties are conduction of heat and electricity. So see here, non-metals are bad conductors of heat and electricity except graphite. So see here student, non-metals are bad conductors of heat and electricity except graphite, which is an allotrope of carbon, which is a very good conductor of electricity. So see here, graphite is good conductor of heat and electricity. This is the exceptional case. So density of non-metals have non-metals having low densities and metals having high densities. So see here, melting points and boiling points. Non-metals have low melting point and boiling point except the solid non-metal carbon and boron melt at high temperature. All the metals and non-metals having लो मेल्टिंग पॉइंट एंड लो बॉइलिंग पॉइंट एक्सेप्ट कार्बन एंड बोरॉन दीज नॉन मेटल्स मेल्ट एट हाई टेम्परेचर. सो स्टूडेंट्स आई थिंक ऑल ऑफ यू अंडरस्टैंड द फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. दीज प्रॉपर्टीज आर वेरी वेरी ईजी. फ्रॉम दीज प्रॉपर्टीज यू मस्ट हैव टू राइट डाउन द डिफरेंस बिटवीन मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. सी हियर यू यूज ऑल दीज प्रॉपर्टी टू राइट डाउन द डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन देम. सो स्टूडेंट्स नाउ वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द नेक्स्ट वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द मेटलॉइड्स. सम एलिमेंट्स सच एज आर्सेनिक सिलिकॉन जर्मेनियम एंटीमनी हैव प्रॉपर्टीज विच आर इंटरमीडिएट बिटवीन मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. सो सच एलिमेंट्स आर कॉल्ड एज मेटलॉइड्स. सो मोर एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ मेटलॉइड्स आर बोरॉन एंड टेलुरियम. सी हियर द एलिमेंट्स विच शोज द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स और विच शोज द इंटरमीडिएट प्रॉपर्टीज बिटवीन मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स सच एलिमेंट्स आर कॉल्ड एज मेटलॉइड्स. सो दीज आर द सम एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ मेटलॉइड्स. सो सी हियर स्टूडेंट्स नेक्स्ट वी सी द केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स एंड मेटलॉइड्स. सो सी हियर व्हाट आर द केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज. सो सी फर्स्ट इज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक configuration. This part we see in the fifth lesson inside the atom. So electronic configuration is the basis of chemical behavior of elements. Majority of metals have up to 3 electrons in their outermost shell. So see here there are some examples: sodium, magnesium and aluminium. So atomic number of sodium is 11, magnesium is 12 and aluminium is 13. We write the electronic configuration of these metals. Sodium having electronic configuration 281, magnesium having electronic configuration 282 and aluminium having electronic configuration 283. Students, how to write electronic configuration? This part we see in the fifth lesson inside the atom. So these are the valence electrons. Sodium having one valence electron, magnesium having two valence electrons and aluminium having three valence electrons. So see here, for attaining this stability, that sodium, magnesium and aluminium, they have to attain stability, means they have to complete its octet or duplet in its outermost shell. For that, all these metals gives the valence electrons in outermost shell to any other element. So it gives electron. So see here, electron, all the metals having electronic configuration, or the majority of metals having up to 3 electrons in their outermost shell, and because of that metals gives the valence electrons in their outermost shell to to any other element, and because of that giving electron, so electrons having one electron having one negative charge, so if metal lose their valence electrons, because of that the positive charge on the metal is increases and it forms positively charged ion, and that positively charged ion is called as cation. So this is the second property of metal, that is formation of ion. So see here, that is sodium. So electronic configuration of sodium is 281. It gives the outermost valence electron 1 to any other element. So one positive charge, see here student, this we show you this is the one positive charge on sodium because it gives the one electron. See here, magnesium gives two electrons. So magnesium having two positive charges because it gives two electrons. And aluminium gives three electrons. So aluminium having three positive charges on it. And their cation is formed, that is called as sodium ion, magnesium ion or aluminium ion. So students, I think all of you understand how ion is formed. Okay, see here student, next we see the next chemical property of metal is reaction with oxygen. So see here, metals combine with oxygen to form their oxides. So see here students, if metal combines with oxygen, it forms metal oxide. So see here, suppose magnesium is react with oxygen, so magnesium oxide is formed here. So see here student, we write the reaction here. If two elements of magnesium reacts with oxygen, it gives magnesium MgO, that is twice MgO. This is the reaction of metal. Magnesium reacts with oxygen, it forms magnesium oxide. See here, the metal oxides are basic in nature. Metal oxide react with an acid to form salt and water. So this is the reaction of water. So reaction with oxygen, see here student, all the metals react with oxygen to form their oxide. All of you, I think all of you understand. Next reaction is reaction with acid. See here, what is the reaction? Take dilute hydrochloric acid in a test tube, then add zinc dust to it. Take a glowing splinter near the mouth of the tube. Observe the glowing splinter. You will notice some sound coming from it. See here, what we have to do? We have to take dilute hydrochloric acid in a test tube and we have to add zinc dust to it. After some time, you will hear some sound. So the sound is of hydrogen gas. So if metal is react with dilute acid to form a metal salt while hydrogen gas is released. So what is the important in that students? If metal reacts with acids, it releases hydrogen gas and metal salt is formed here. So see next reaction with water. In this reaction, most metal do not show any observable and fast reaction with cold water, but some metals like sodium and potassium react with cold water to produce their hydroxides and hydrogen gas. Magnesium metal requires steam to give similar reaction. So see here, most of metals do not show any observable reaction with water, but exception are the sodium and potassium reacts with cold water and it produces hydroxide and hydrogen gas. So see a student, I going to tell you one thing about the interesting thing about the sodium. Sodium is highly reactive with water and it produces a cracking noise and it liberates the hydrogen gas. So sodium is stored in kerosene. Always sodium is stored in kerosene because it have very fast reaction with cold water. So see here student, these are all about the chemical properties of metal. So all of you write down all these chemical properties of metals in your notebook. So students, now we discussed about the केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ नॉन मेटल्स. सो सी हियर, फर्स्ट केमिकल प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ नॉन मेटल इज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन. मोस्ट ऑफ द नॉन मेटल्स हैव 4 to 7 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन देयर वैलेंस शेल. सो सी हियर स्टूडेंट्स, नाइट्रोजन इज देयर, ऑक्सीजन इज देयर एंड क्लोरीन इज देयर. सो एटॉमिक नंबर ऑफ नाइट्रोजन इज 7. सो इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन इज 2 and 5. एटॉमिक नंबर ऑफ ऑक्सीजन इज 8. सो इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन इज 2, 6. एटॉमिक नंबर ऑफ क्लोरीन इज 17. सो इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन इज 2, 8 and 7. सो दीज नॉन मेटल्स हैव टू अटेन द स्टेबिलिटी बाय एक्वायरिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन्स फ्रॉम अदर एलिमेंट्स टू अटेन स्टेबिलिटी और टू कंप्लीट द ऑक्टेट और डुप्लेट इन इट्स आउटर मोस्ट शेल. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट ही गिव्स और द नॉन मेटल हैव द टेंडेंसी टू एक्सेप्ट द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन देयर वैलेंस शेल टू फॉर्म ए निगेटिवली चार्ज्ड आयन एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड एज कैटायन. सो सी हियर स्टूडेंट्स, क्लोरीन हैविंग द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन 2, 8, 7 एंड इन वैलेंस सेल और इन लास्ट सेल वैलेंस इलेक्ट्रॉन इज 7. क्लोरीन डज नॉट गिव 7 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स टू एनी अदर एलिमेंट बट इट एक्सेप्ट्स द 1 इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्रॉम एनी अदर एलिमेंट एंड इट कंप्लीट्स इट्स ऑक्टेट इन आउटर मोस्ट सेल एंड एक्वायर स्टेबिलिटी. डूइंग दिस द by accepting 1 electron, the negative charge on chlorine is increased by 1. See here, there is a negative charge. So, chloride ion is formed. Like oxygen, valence electrons of oxygen are 6. So, oxygen having 2 electrons to complete its octet and it accepts 2 electrons from other element and because of that, oxide ion is formed and that ion having 2 negative charges. See here, nitrogen is there. You study and because of that, nitrogen gives 3 electrons from other element and it forms nitride ion. So this is property. This property is called as formation of ions. Student, please remember that metals always form cation because they lose their valence electrons and non-metals always forms anions because they accept the electrons in their valence shells. This is the main difference between metal and non-metal. So next we see next reaction, that is reaction with oxygen. So what is the reaction with oxygen? Non-metals combine with oxygen to form their oxide. So any non-metal reacts with oxygen to form oxide. So see here, if carbon is react with, see here student, if carbon is react with, carbon is a non-metal, if that non-metal is react with oxygen O2, it gives non-metal oxide, that is CO2, carbon dioxide. This is the example of reaction with oxygen. So see here, the oxides of non-metals are acidic in nature. They react with bases to form soluble salt and water. See here, this is the reaction. Carbon plus O2, it gives CO2. And next, if oxides of non-metals are in acidic, they react with bases. NaOH, sodium hydroxide is a base. If CO2 is react with base, it forms the soluble salt. This is the sodium carbonate and water, that is salt and water. So see here next, the oxides of non-metals react with water to form an acid. एनी ऑक्साइड ऑफ नॉन मेटल दैट इज कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड रिएक्ट विथ वाटर इट फॉर्म कार्बोनिक एसिड. सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड रिएक्ट विथ वाटर इट फॉर्म सल्फ्यूरस एसिड. एंड सल्फर ट्राइऑक्साइड इज रिएक्ट विथ वाटर इट फॉर्म सल्फ्यूरिक एसिड. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द रिएक्शन ऑफ नॉन मेटल विथ ऑक्सीजन. एंड लास्ट रिएक्शन इज नॉन मेटल्स डू नॉट रिएक्ट विथ एनी डाइल्यूट एसिड. नॉन मेटल्स डू नॉट रिएक्ट विथ एनी डाइल्यूट एसिड. सो सी योर स्टूडेंट्स, टूडे वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द फिजिकल एंड केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. ऑल ऑफ यू मस्ट राइट डाउन दीज प्रॉपर्टीज इन यूअर नोटबुक एंड यू हैव टू राइट डाउन द मेजर डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स इन यूअर नोटबुक. आई थिंक ऑल ऑफ यू अंडरस्टैंड्स ऑल दीज पॉइंट्स. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट प्लीज आस्क मी. एंड प्लीज स्टूडेंट प्लीज सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल. Because of that, you get the notification of next video. Thank you so much.